Hello, welcome. Welcome friends, family, and community members. My name is Julie Novak, and I am the music director, music therapist here at the Colorado School for the Deaf and the Blind. Thank you so much for showing up tonight. In an era where state assessments are used to measure worth, I'm so thankful for an administration and a school that values the arts and encourages us to teach the whole child. I've been doing this job for over a decade, and your son and daughter's talents never cease to amaze me. In fact, they wrote a musical. How about that? So tonight, all of what you see is a play that they created themselves. We have songs that they composed, and they wrote the lyrics to, with a few additions of, you know, Joan Jett, Ray Charles. But most of the songs are theirs. One of my favorite moments of the show and one of my favorite songs that they wrote is one that I just think kind of encapsulates this whole program, which is Don't Underestimate Us. The title of the song is Don't Underestimate Us. I hope tonight that you're able to put away the stresses of a busy end of the school year and just take a deep breath and be present with these talented, wonderful children up on the stage. Thank you so much for coming. It is my pleasure and honor to introduce our wonderful principal, Miss Jamie Lugo.
Hello, everyone. Welcome. Laryngitis at the end of the school year, that shows it's been a good year, right? So I've lost my voice a little bit, but so good to see all of you. I'm so excited for you to see this performance. It's a great example of what project-based learning is all about. Project-based learning is when collaboration goes on between different teachers, different classrooms, subject areas. So there was collaboration with the English department, writing the musical, helping with the songs and the grammar and all of that that's involved. Of course, the music department was a huge part. You'll see a go-ball scene where there was some physical education involved, art, some of the background and displays. It was such a great collaboration piece between staff members and students, and just so excited for you guys to see this, and thank you so much for coming this evening. It is my pleasure to introduce Ms. Carol Hilty, our superintendent. Enjoy.
Good evening, everyone. It's great to see all of you. I love these occasions when we can come together and when we can watch your children and our students perform. Most people are surprised to learn that I'm a fan of Dancing with the Stars. I don't know if that just doesn't fit with my typical job responsibilities or what, but this season has been especially fascinating because if you're not aware, one of the dancers is totally deaf. And it became evident last night when he won the championship. And I thought what was so powerful about that was what one of the judges had to say. And that was that there are no limitations for people, only the limitations we put on ourselves. And I think it's such a great coincidence that that occurred last night and our students from the School for the Blind are performing tonight. Because as Julie mentioned, the arts are so important. Sometimes that's where our students most excel. And if they can find a place to excel, everything else becomes a little bit easier. So at CSDB, we do value the whole child, and we do value the arts. And I've watched our students this year, and they have just transformed. From the beginning of the year, I would go as far as to say, if you were here for the winter program, you are in for a huge surprise. Because where they were in December and where they are now is just amazing. They are so talented, they are so enthusiastic, and it's because we have, I think, such a tremendous staff along with you as family members that support them and give them that encouragement to do and be whatever it is they want to be. So I agree with what Jamie said, sit back. It's the end of the school year, it's a great time, great evening to be here. Relax and enjoy our students, your children, they're just awesome. And our staff has done a tremendous job. So thanks to all of you for being here. Enjoy.
Are you ready to go in?
I don't want to go.
Are you okay?
I'm not okay. I guess I'm just a little bit nervous about going to school.
What are you so nervous about?
Well, what if they don't accept me? What if I don't make any friends? I'm scared of what they're going to think of me. And what if they judge me because of my eye condition?
Don't worry about it. Just be yourself. Don't let any words get to you. You've got to be strong. You are in charge of who you are. You determine who you are, not them.
But what if they don't like me?
They're going to love you. You're loving and caring and smart and kind, and everyone is going to want to meet you. You're going to do just great. You'll be fine. Wow, I see you're frustrated. I've been there before, and I know that you'll have fun on your first day. You'll make some friends and have a great time.
I don't believe it, it's too good to be true. And the kids, they'll be mean, just like every other place I've been. Why should I believe it's true? It never ends.
You'll do just fine. Just remember all the things I told you, you'll do just fine. You'll have the greatest memories you'll ever know.
What should I say? Why do I let my hopes, they fly away? And everything's not easy, and everyone excludes me now.
You'll do just fine. Just remember all the things I told you. You'll do just fine. You'll have the greatest memories you'll ever know. You'll do just fine.
Whatever you say.
The paper that I had, I thought I had it a little bit earlier. Man, this is so frustrating. I can't even find this piece of paper. It's so frustrating.
Is this the principal's office?
Ugh, you scare me. But yes, in fact, you're talking to the principal.
Oh, you're the principal. Hi, I'm Penny Lane.
Yes, I know who you are. Your mom and I met the day you first came to visit. She told me so much about you and how awesome you are.
Oh.
Welcome to Spring School for the Blind.
Oh.
You're going to love here. You will learn so many things, including all classes plus a few ECC classes.
What's ECC?
What's ECC? That's easy. Hit it, band. Expanded core curriculum. 9 different classes you are in. Learn to cook and how to clean and show social skills to your army.
What is this?
There's recreation and game use. Resources that you can't refuse. Plus UEB or modern world. And street crossings you dare not fail. You'll learn to use the microwave, how to spend the money safe. You'll learn to budget for a lot of food and behave right, whatever your mood. There is a bunch to ECC, your master all for your degree. Make change into arithmetics while educating the public. You'll learn from pressure from your peers, navigating all your fears. And just to finish off the scene, there's one last class about hygiene that covers most of ECC, explicitly told to you by me. You'll learn rec skills, especially in the band. Now ECC, do you understand?
Kind of.
Maybe you need a refrain.
No, I'm good.
You know what? I insist. Help me out here, stuff. Expanded core curriculum, 9 different classes you are in. You learn to cook and how to clean and social skills to your army. There's recreation and king youth, resources they can't refuse. Plus UEB or modern bro, and street crossings you dare not fail.
Uh-oh, you stuck again.
Oh! That covers most of ECC, explicitly told to you by me. You learn rec skills, especially in the band. Now ECC, do you understand?
Yes, now can I please put this stuff down?
Sure. Maybe I need to fix some of this stuff up. Do you remember how to get around the building?
I think so.
Would you like me to show you to your classes?
No, thanks. I'm good.
Okay. Well, if you need anything else, you know where my office is.
Okay. Thanks for the help.
What's the answer to number 2?
Oh, me. Who's that girl over there?
Oh, hi, my name is Mrs. Lee Gary. And who are you?
Oh, hi, I'm Penny Lane.
Class, say hello to Penny.
Hi.
It's nice to meet you, Penny. Is there anything we can help you with?
Yeah, is this the English classroom?
No, I'm sorry, it's not. It's the science room. The English room is out the door, to the right, make another right, and it's the first classroom on the left.
Okay, thanks.
Would you like someone to help you?
No, thanks, I'm fine.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, what is that thing?
I see you have met our classroom skeleton. That's Larry. Oh, and he's smiling. It looks like you bumped his funny bone. Hey, Penny, it's the
other right.
Hi, I think so too.
Oh man, I can't find anywhere to sit. How did I get into this situation?
Hey, watch where you're going.
Oh, I'm so sorry. I didn't see you there.
You should be. What are you, blind? These were new shoes.
Yeah, I'm blind. Aren't you? This is a school for the blind, right? Anyway, is there anything I can do to help?
No, it's fine. Whatever.
Did you just see what happened? What's her
problem? I know, right? I mean, what's up with her?
You're going to be joining us today. You're going to need 2 elbow pads, 2 knee pads, and 1 blindfold.
Why? What are we doing?
We're playing goalball. Haven't you ever heard of it before?
No, never. What is it?
Goalball is a game with 3 positions: center, left wing, and right wing. Johnson, let's demonstrate.
I'm right beside you.
The center squats, and you'll jump to your side to keep the ball from not passing you. The left wing defends the left. The right wing defends the right.
I'm bushed.
Toughen up, Johnson. Both positions kneel while waiting for the ball. You have to use your listening skills, and you'll be fine. You'll go be the center position. And remember,
never take off the blindfold.
Here you go, Penny.
Good luck, Penny.
Anymore.
Penny, are you okay?
How badly does it hurt?
Penny, it's goal ball 101 here. Use your arms to block your face. Pen, can you toughen up a bit? Zach, come here. Why don't you take Penny down to the nurse to get her nose looked at?
Yes, coach. Penny, are you okay?
This is the worst day ever.
What? Why?
Because of everything. And I started it.
You know what, Penny, I get it. You're having a rough day, and you know what? That's okay. You're gonna get through it. We all have rough days, and we have to be okay with it.
Why?
Because if we have rough days, we can look forward to having very good days. You never know how good a day can turn out to be when we have something bad happen.
But when will I have a good day?
You know what? I don't know when you're going to have a good day. In fact, that's not my decision. That's your decision. If you want to have a good rest of your day, try to find the best out of every situation, and maybe you'll see that this bad day will turn into a really good day. You see, Penny, every day is a new day to start over. Why not start now? Today is day one.
I had a short term memory. I wish the only thing my eyes could see was a future burning bright right in front of me. But I can't stop looking back. Yeah, I wish I was a perfect picture of somebody who's never not good enough. I try to measure up, but I mess it up. And I wish I wasn't like that. Well, I wish I wasn't wishing anymore. I wish I could smell the vitamins, keep the door. I'm tired throwing things in the well. I gotta do something. Here goes nothing. It's day one of the rest of my life. It's day one of the rest of my life. I'm marching onto the heat of a brand new gun. It's here I come. The future has begun. It's day one. like that right in front of you. Whatever may come that wants to haunt you, never lay them behind you. Well, our first day is shrinking down. Second bite says no make them count. So hurry up and get back up. This day one has begun. Well, I don't wish anymore. It's gonna never look back and score her. I've tried to throw it in the well. I gotta do something. Here goes nothing.
You know what? You're right. I want to go back to the gym, and right now.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm positive. You know what? You're right. Today is day one. I want to go back and make it right, because I know I can do better.
All right, let's go.
Where's your cane? Oh, I forgot it.
You forgot it? Are you sure?
Yeah. I just forgot it at home. I really don't need it. Yeah, I see fine.
You know, you should really use your cane. It'll protect you from running into things.
You like using your cane? Why?
Did you know that it helps you let other people know that you have a visual impairment? It protects you from running into things, but it also helps you let other people know that you might not be able to see them. I love my white cane, and I even got a song for it.
You do?
Yes, and I also hear you play keyboard. Care to join in?
I'd love to.
I love my white cane. It helps me with independence. It also helps blind people, and it protects you when you sweep it side to side. Oh yeah. I
thank you.
Now that I've signed you all jobs, I will leave for a bit and check in with you in a few minutes to see how you are doing.
Okay.
Hey, Penny, do you know what you're doing? Do you know how to cut things? Well, I'm amazed. Good job.
I hate it when people think we can't be independent just because we're blind. It really gets on my nerves.
Don't touch, don't help, we'll get it done. Don't need your help, you're not the one. You can't do it by yourself. We don't need you, you can't tell. That's what they say, but I say,
don't underestimate us.
Don't underestimate us. Don't underestimate us. We got this, don't make a fuss. But I must remind them that I say,
don't underestimate us.
Don't underestimate us.
I said, don't underestimate us.
Cause we got this, believe in us. Don't underestimate us. Don't underestimate us.
I said, don't underestimate us.
Cause we got this, believe in us.
Hey, Miss Smith, why don't you come over here and check how well Penny is cutting her food?
Okay, show me.
Oh no! Oh, my finger! I cut off my finger! Ah!
What's so funny?
April Fools!
Retirement can't come soon enough.
Okay, so you've seen your room, the kitchen, and the laundry facilities. This is our living room. And over to your left is our video collection.
Oh, well, hey, I heard you guys have a game of Wii Bowling going on over there. This place is like a hotel for kids.
Yes, Penny, it's like a hotel, except you have to practice your ECC skills too, like cleaning up after yourself, making your bed, cooking, and other chores. No maid service here.
Aww. But what happens if another student misses their parents and gets homesick?
We have kids calling their folks all the time.
Other kids miss their parents too?
Yes, Penny, it's normal to miss your parents. And before you call your mom, the kids want to know if you want to join their dorm jam session. Or did you play piano? Is that correct?
Yes.
All right, she said yes, guys.
Yeah!
Let's get stuff situated.
Thank you.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, Penny, it's your mom.
Oh, thanks.
Hello, Penny. How was your first day?
Well, to be honest with you, Mom, I wasn't quite sure I was going to make it here at first. One bad thing after another kept happening to me. But then I met a friend, and his name is Zach, and he told me that every moment is a new opportunity to start over and make things better. He sang me a song about it, and it goes something like this.
It's day one of the rest of my life. It's day one of the best of my life. I'm marching on to the beat of a brand new drum. Now here I come, the future has begun. It's day one.
Still there, Penny?
Oh, sorry, Mom. I forgot you were still on the line.
I'm so glad it was a good first day. I'm off to the store. I'll talk to you later. I love you. Goodbye.
Bye.
Attention all students. We have a new student here. Her name is Amanda.
Hi, Amanda!
Here in the dorms, they practice a lot of their ECC skills.
What's ECC?
Don't ask!
I'll explain. Expanded core curriculum, 9 different classes you are in, learn to cook and how to clean, and social skills, the army.
Hey guys, let's do one more jam before we go to bed. Just one. Whoa, wipe out!
Thank you.
so much for being such a great audience to the show. Here's the whole cast of Blindsided. One more bow. And the Bulldog Band. Everyone stand up. Woo! Thank you so much goes into this production. I couldn't do it alone. I definitely need so much support. I so appreciate it. I would like to acknowledge facilities, Bruce and Bobby and Kyle Byrne. Thank you so much. Can you guys give me a hand? Thank you so much to Sean Levier and Outreach. Because of him and his talents, this is able to be broadcasted all around the world. Please tell your friends and family about it. Imagine trying to interpret that expanded core curriculum song in a different language. Can you believe it? Imagine our interpreter, Marcy. Thank you so much. Thank you so much to all of the residential staff and the staff from the School for the Blind for all your support of this production. I have some special people who work backstage. It is a thankless job. It's hot and muggy back there, but I couldn't do it without them. Everyone who helped backstage, please come out. Thank you. Thank you so much, Joyce and Evelyn and Mr. Bristol. And I would be remiss if I didn't give a special thank you to Mr. Bristol. Come on out. Come out behind the skeleton. And Jeremy Gray. Thanks again for coming out tonight. We have refreshments. Please feel free to stay and chat for a while. As you're leaving, we have an extra encore performance, if that's okay. Can I hit you with your best shot? Come out.
Before everybody leaves, we need to give a shout out to Miss Novak, because she's the one who made most of this possible. We wouldn't be here without her. So give her a huge round of applause. All right. All right, let's go.